Explain to me.
This is the shelter.
Yeah.
This is called a shelter.
Yeah.
So in that, what happened? We are placing BTS inside the shelter.
Yeah.
Shelter room. Shelter room is there, which is kept on the two rolls.
Rolls.
Grounded to the earth pit.
I must show that this is the roof. BTS. Yeah. Okay. Continue.
This in that center, what happened? We are placing various types of operators are working there, na?
Yeah.
So we are placing, suppose there is a sharing of, this is Reliance Infocom.
This is the Reliance,
Infocom is, it's a infrastructure providing.
Yeah.
It's okay.
Yeah.
There are various types of, this is a Reliance sharing. There is the Indus sharing, so SR sharing, so Vodafone sharing, or it's a OAM sharing.
Yeah.
Various types of sharing infrastructures are GTL sharing, GIL sharing, like that.
Okay.
So we are using here the infrastructure of Reliance Infocom.
Yeah.
In that we are suppose our operator is Vodafone.
Okay.
We are placing that Vodafone 2G BTS inside the BTS. Sorry, inside the shelter room, and it's the proposed BTS. Yes.
What's the meaning of proposed BTS?
Proposed BTS means the they have given us the proposed BTS is Vodafone. 2G BTS, we have to place indoor BTS. It's called indoor BTS.
Okay.
If there is no space available in the shelter,
then
we can place here. Or it's outdoor site.
Okay.
Outdoor location. It's called as outdoor BTS.
Okay.
Then BTS type will get changed. You are placing inside the shelter room. So it is indoor BTS.
Yeah.
If you are placing in outdoor, it is outdoor BTS.
Yeah.
There are difference between indoor and outdoor BTS.
Yeah.
Indoor BTS doesn't have a fan, but outdoor BTS has a fan at the door end.
I think it's vice versa. Indoor like needs fan.
Indoor doesn't need fan because there is AC inside the shelter.
Cooling
system is there. But outdoor BTS doesn't have a cooling system. It is called as outdoor BTS and it's provided with exhaust fan. Which is continuously running. Exhaust fan. It's a type of BTS where you have another type of BTS is there which can also be placed on the tower. It's called as the tower top BTS. It's a stack mount BTS. Types of BTS are there. So we need this tower. This is pole tower.
Okay.
Pole tower on which we are going to install these antennas, GSM antennas. Here assembling is going on there.
Yeah. Okay.
And these are GSM antennas. There are three sectors.
Yeah.
First, second, and third.
Yeah.
Likewise, they are given with TSSR, means technical site survey report. They have given, in which we are given sector 1, sector 2, and sector 3.
Yeah.
Proposed. And their azimuth is given. Azimuth.
Yeah.
So likewise we have to install the antenna on the pole tower.
Yeah.
Or it may be proposed like that you are looking there. It is a RTT.
R?
Yeah, rooftop tower.
Okay.
So on roof and there is a tower. So RTT.
Yeah.
This is a on roof RTP. It's called as RTP. Rooftop pole. Rooftop pole. On roof poles are there.
Yeah.
And GBT is there, but here it is in city there is no GBT. GBT is on outside area of the city.
Yeah.
GBT means ground based station tower.
Yeah.
Ground based tower. Okay. And here it is our feeder cable and roof.
This one.
It's a feeder cable.
Okay.
We have to connect this GSM antenna with the BTS.
Is there anything special that you want to talk about the feeder?
Yeah.
Is there anything special that you want to talk about the details of?
It's a coaxial type feeder.
Uh-huh.
Is that clear? And we have to make, in that means what happens, the RF waves, RF signals are provided to antennas.
Uh-huh.
And from antennas to BTS.
Yeah.
In duplex arrangement. Each sector has main and diversity. There are two feeders are there. Two cables are connected to antenna. And that cables are connected to BTS end in duplexer.
Yeah.
I will show you duplexer.
Okay. Is there anything special for the?
I will show you. Here it is the. It's a cavity there. This is the outer core.
Mm-hmm.
It's a shield insulation.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a central core.
Yes,
it's central. A cavity you call this.
Cavity.
It's a copper cable totally.
Yeah. Okay.
And on it, we have to make a connector, feeder connector.
Yeah.
And just we have to connect to the our antenna.
Antenna.
GSM antenna.
Mm-hmm. Can you show me?
Here it is. Actually, the antenna type is different type.
Mm-hmm.
Means this is a four port antenna. Four port antenna. There are four ports.
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Show me again.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Okay.
There are also two port antennas also there, but its size is big.
Big.
Because it is four port antenna.
Mm-hmm.
And two port antennas are smaller than this. Because you can see there, it's a two port antenna there.
Yeah.
There. Not this one.
Mm-hmm.
Two port antenna size is less.
Yeah.
Than this. What happened here? You can see there are two ports, na?
Yeah.
So frequencies of Vodafone. It's used for Vodafone, na?
Yeah.
So Vodafone frequencies is Vodafone 2G.
Mm-hmm.
Vodafone 2G working on frequency 900 band.
900.
GSM 900.
Yeah.
GSM 900.
Yeah.
Working on. So these two ports are provided with 900 band frequency.
Mm-hmm.
Here it is written 824 to 960 megahertz frequency. There. It's a plus 45 means TX. It's a TX.
TX.
And minus 45 means RX.
RX. Yeah.
It's main. It's a diversity.
Uh-huh.
Okay. But these two ports are used for GSM 2G, 900 band.
Yeah.
2G. And these are TX and RX. Sorry, this is TX and this is minus. Means diversity.
Diversity.
These are from band of 1710 to 2180. It's a 3G band. Used for 3G BTS.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So it's a 2G, it's a 3G.
Mm-hmm.
Vodafone is working on this principle. 3G frequency is higher than the 2G.
Frequency of 3G is higher
than 2G.
Yeah.
Because it's a 1710 to 2810 megahertz.
Mm-hmm.
This is 900 band, 824 to 960 megahertz.
Okay.
So three antennas are there.
Yeah. Okay.
And these are used, is called as electrical tilt.
Tilt.
It's a focusing angle.
Yeah.
Electrical focusing. And mechanical tilt is also there because if
this
there
is electric or
electrical tilt, internal.
Yeah? In the internal, but
electrical. Mm. Electrical tilt is means we can adjust the coverage.
I know that the tilting from this rotation is called tilting.
No, it's a mechanical tilting. Called mechanical tilting. It is electrical tilting.
Mm-hmm.
You can increase or decrease the beam size of this.
Yeah.
Your antenna.
Yeah.
But mechanical tilting is what you can increase or decrease the coverage of the GSM antenna or the sector.
Yeah.
And that. So, and there are two. Suppose we have installed the BTS.
Yeah.
And you have installed the GSMs on the tower and first, second, and third sectors likewise. And install the feeder. And connected it to the duplexer. Your BTS is there inside the shelter.
Yeah.
After that, you have to make the configuration of the cards. Means there are various types of cards in BTS. You know better. And after that, just give the install the BTS according to the configuration and commission the BTS. Give the power and commission the BTS.
Yeah.
In additional to you have seen there two microwaves are there.
Yeah.
There are two microwaves.
Yeah. Tell me about that.
Microwaves are. It is a
0.6.
Mm-hmm.
Various size of microwave are there.
Diameter.
Yeah, the diameter.
Suppose we are using here 0.6. Means 60 centimeter.
Yeah.
This is the size of our hop.
Mm-hmm.
This is hop. One is installed here.
Mm-hmm.
At this side. You can call this side as a near end.
Mm-hmm.
Near end, and from where we are taking E1 signal link, called as far end.
Yeah.
It's a near end, it's a far end.
Okay.
And just we have to install the one antenna here and one antenna to the far end.
Mm-hmm.
Just commission the IDU, what is the transmission equipment provided there, na?
Yeah.
We have to commission. Give, and it has, actually macros are installed with ODU.
Yeah.
I will show you ODU.
Mm-hmm.
ODU. And yeah. We have to give the TX power and frequency to the ODU.
Yeah.
According to the link budget.
Okay.
Link budget is there that we have to take and just align the microwaves. It's called as alignment. After alignment, some receive level is coming on our laptop or our multimeter. The technicians are going with multimeter.
Okay.
So they got some receive level there. We got properly aligned hop there. After that, we can transfer the even from this link to here, this side, and just give to the make the commissioning there and connect to the BTS. From BSCN, we have to check it. What is the going on there? The loop break is there. Suppose even you know even is there. We have to check the even at the far end. So for example, the even is checked as a loop and break. Loop is there. This TX is shorted with RX.
Mm-hmm.
TX is shorted with RX, even signal is there.
Yeah.
So we have to test with the BSC end or knock. You can call it as a knock. So if you are sitting at far end and shorting TX with RX, looping. So at a BSC end, here is ET port is there.
Mm-hmm.
BSC end, ET port, they are going, they supply ET port number. And if you are giving the loop to the ET, just call to BSC or knock and check the status of your even status.
Mm-hmm.
If he will tell you that there is a loop, it means your even is right.
Mm-hmm.
You will remove the cable, means mm-hmm. you make it open.
Yeah.
Then it should be open at that end, at BSC end. So he will tell you the status that it's a break now. So in that case, even is tested. If you are not getting, you are giving loop there. At the far end side, you are giving loop to the ET. And you are calling to BSC, check the loop.
Yeah.
He is telling that no loop is there.
Mm-hmm.
It's a break. Yes, you are not on proper channel.
Yeah.
On not proper even. Once you have they have confirmed us that you are okay, this even is tested. Loop is, you are giving loop, there is loop. You are breaking it, there is break. Then you are on right channel and right even is reached to the far end. After that you can transfer to BTS and get set into there. That's enough.